So in this first video, I'm going to be showing you how you can design your own font inside of an iPad. You can use paper if you want to with tracing paper, but most of the time I prefer to use an iPad because I can change and edit everything that I need to edit very easily. I'm using Procreate to do this, and I'm using the basic character sheet that you get from Fontself on their app. So you can actually quickly go and download it and bring it onto your iPad. It gives you a basic character set. So it shows you all your basic characters here. So your capitals from A to Z, and then your lowercase a to Z, 1, 0 to 9 even on the numbers, and all your punctuation. But in this video, I'm only going to be focusing on the A to Z in upper and lower case, because you will understand a bit more about the font creation process with that. I'm going to be using a brush pen as well for this, because it makes it easier for me to create a brush script font. But you can create a brush script font even if you don't have brush pens, by just penciling it in. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my first layer here, and I'm going to expand it or scale it up like you can see here. And the reason for that is because I'm not going to be focusing on where the letters should be or in which box they should be in, but I'm going to be focusing on making sure that my letters can scale well within Illustrator. We don't want our sheet or our canvas size to be too small, because then Illustrator will have a hard time image tracing it in. So the typeface that I'm going to be using is this one here, which I'm going to show you, which is I'm going to write hand glove in. Now, the reason why we write hand glove is because it works really well to show what our typeface is going to look like. And this is just a very rough sketch as to what we're doing. So when we use this word hand glove, it shows us the relationships between the letter forms easily because of the letters that we've got in there. So I always start with hand glove to make sure it works. So then I'm going to start doing my characters. So you can see here on the A, I'm going to go up to the top ascender line, even though sometimes people don't do that. And I'm just going to quickly put in my words and make sure it's all balanced. The great thing about using a grid like this is that it enables us to understand the relationships between our letters. So we can see how thick and thin they are based off of everything else. And as I'm going through this, you can see how it's working together. If I make a mistake, I'll just rub it out like so. H-I-J. And this is like kind of my rough stage when it comes to designing a font. So I'm just getting the basics down. And we can refine this as we go along. So we've got a caps here, and now we can go over to our lowercase. Now our lowercase letters have to start here for most of the time, which is the X height. This is the descender height, and this is the ascender height, and this is where we can overshoot to the ascender. Now what you want to keep in mind is when you're designing this font is that we want to keep it uniform all the way along, but we want to keep it consistent. And that means that the connector lines have to be very consistent to the point of where they're nearly a copy of the other connector lines. This depends on the type of font you're creating. Today we're creating a very loose font to make it easier for me to show you, but if I just to do the A here like so, here's an A, you can see this connector line. We want that connector line to be similar all the way through the font. So we see the B, we go up to the ascender line, we've got a B, we don't want a connector line for the B, but the C we do want a connector line. But as you can see here, I went a bit too far over. I want the thicknesses to be the same all the way through as well. Now, for instance, if you just wanted to do your handwriting, you can do this a bit differently. But if we're designing a professional font, we want to make sure that it works and gives us the best outcome possible. And doing that means that we have to have the right connector line. So I'm just making sure that connector line is very similar to this one. F can be a tricky one, but we'll just try it and we can always edit it later. G is also a difficult one, because we can go to the connector line down here. H has got an ascender on it, so we're just going to do the H on the ascender. I, and you can see I'm trying to keep all these connector lines just right, just the same as they should be. You can see there that we've got a bit of a strange angle here, so I'm just going to move this to a separate angle like so. Another good reason to use an iPad. We've got an L, which we want to keep in line with the I, because it's just a big I without the dot. And when that connector line is a bit too big or too much, we can just bring it down a bit like that. So now I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of these. And once we're done, I'm going to show you how to refine them. Now that we've got all the letter forms from A to Z, all done, lowercase and uppercase, we can go ahead and start refining them. And this is the way that I do it, which may be different to other people. But the way that I like to refine this is by duplicating the layer so we don't mess around with it or lose it. And I'm going to scale it up. Now, the reason why I'm scaling it up is to give it a bit more fidelity. And we will lose some of the letter forms, but do not worry because we have duplicated the letters down here. If you're doing this on paper, what you would need to do is just to scan in and then print it off with larger letter forms on the print sheet and trace around the bigger print sheet so you get a higher fidelity. Now, this is really important if you're image tracing your font into Illustrator, because the higher the fidelity or the higher res that you've got these letter forms, the better Illustrator can pick it out. If you're doing this and you're just going to vectorize it like I show you using the pen tool, then it's not so much of an issue. So I'm going to bring all my letter forms down to the middle here, and I'm going to change the opacity to lower down. Reason being is because I'm going to trace it over the top with a sketching pencil, just a normal pencil. Now the same applies. All we're going to do now is refine this by going over it a bit more intentionally with the pencil. So each curve in each corner is intentionally created. This gives us a lot more control because now I can sketch them out, get rid of them, and still keep it loose. So I'm going to do this for each letter form, which is basically making sure that everything is consistent around the letter form. And again, this is just a fun font for anyone who wants to use it. But the ability of this means that I've got good curves everywhere that I can easily use to trace back in using the pencil on Illustrator. So I'm going to go ahead and go through all of these, and then by the end, we should have a really nice set of letter forms that we can use. So now that we've revised the typeface, you can see here that it's a bit more up straight and not italicized. The capital letters are actually a bit longer as well. But what we need to do now is take this revised version and put it into our computer. And you can do this by saving it, or if you have paper, you can scan it, use your smartphone, take a picture of it and bring it in. All we need is a really high fidelity picture that we can use to image trace the letter forms into Illustrator. Once we've image traced the letter forms, we can then go ahead and vectorize them for a different option. So I'm going to be showing you two options. One that is very loose, that is just based around this, and another option that allows you to vectorize it, which gives you a very clean typeface look.